Are you in a place now where you are wondering what is happening in your life? You look around you and everything seems to be falling apart. Nothing looks familiar. Nothing looks like the promise of God or the word of God being fulfilled in your life. If this is your testimony, then God has a word of encouragement and truth for you today. Have you ever struggled with something and wondered why it has been happening to you? There are things that happen to you that shake you up so much that it seems like they would break you apart completely. Things that seem like they come just to mess up God's plan for your life. Struggles and situations that make you wonder if what God said is really true. Things that make you question everything you thought you previously knew. Sometimes they are attacked from the enemy, and other times you are not even sure what the problem really is. You pray and you fast. You study the word. You profess God's word over the situation and nothing seems to change. Rather, things may even look like they are starting to get worse. Whatever you do, nothing seems to make any kind of difference. You cry out to God and it seems like He's turned His back on you. You pray and His presence feels so far away. You know the word. You know His promise that He will not leave you or forsake you. But in this moment and in this season, you feel so utterly alone that it is hard to just keep on believing with no proof or anything to show that He is still with you. Prayer suddenly feels like a monologue, like a one-way conversation that doesn't even go beyond your ceiling. You try to hold on, but you are tired. You've heard not to give up, but you are just so very tired. You even begin to wish that you could give up, but you can't. You may even begin to wonder if you haven't just been lying to yourself all this time. You begin to wonder if you made up all the times God spoke to you and all the times you experienced His presence, because it just feels like a lie in that moment, like something you can't get back. And that's the worst, isn't it? Because if you'd never experienced it, you wouldn't know what you were missing now. If you had never experienced the goodness and the grace and the presence of God, it wouldn't be so difficult right now. You wouldn't feel like you had lost something. If this is where you are right now, I want to tell you first of all that I understand what you are going through. You are not alone in this journey. It is because you are not alone in this that God is sending you His word today. His word of strength and of encouragement. God has asked me to remind you today that He hasn't forgotten you. No matter where you are right now or what situation you're going through, no matter how dark and hopeless it seems, yes, it may look like things will never get better because it has gone on for so long, but I bring you a word of encouragement from the Lord. I have come to tell you that when the Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning, it is really true. As we see in the book of Psalms, the 30th chapter, the 5th verse, it may be difficult right now, but that situation did not come to put an end to you. It didn't come to kill your vision. No matter what it is, there is nothing that God is unprepared for. You may be in the valley of the shadow of death, but God is still with you. There is such a wonderful promise of God to you that He wants to remind you of today. It is a little bit long, but stay with me. It is going to be more than worth it. In the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, Paul tells us, "What shall we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can ever be against us? Since He did not spare even His own Son, but gave Him up for us all, won't He also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us, whom God has chosen for His own? No one, for God Himself has given us right standing with Himself. Who then will condemn us? No one, for Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life for us. And He is sitting in the place of honor at God's right hand, pleading for us. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean He no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened with death? No, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. There is nothing that can separate you, my friend, from the love of Christ, no matter what it is. Yes, no accusation, no sin, nothing you can do can make God turn his back on you. Paul says, if God is for us, who can be against us? Child of God, God is for you. Did you know that? You are his chosen one. According to 1 Peter, the 2nd chapter, the 9th verse, you are not an accident. He chose you. And if he chose you, best believe there is nothing you will ever go through that he is not aware of. There is no situation that you will ever face that will ever surprise or shock him. Nothing that happens in your life is news to him, no matter what it is. Don't allow the devil to lie to you and deceive you that you are on your own. You may not feel his presence, but he is surely there. As sure as the air you are breathing right now, as sure as the words you are hearing right now, your God has not abandoned you. The psalmist says, even if I descend to the depths of hell, you will still be with me. In the book of Psalms, the 139th chapter, the 8th verse, that's how much he's committed to you. He, my friend, may be silent, but that doesn't mean he's not working behind the scenes of your life. You may not see what he's doing right now. It may not make any sense. You may even be saying, God is not working in my life. I am the one who got myself into this situation. But I tell you the truth, no mistake is greater than the story God is writing of your life. He chose you as his own even before he laid the foundations of the earth. Did you know that? Isn't that mind-blowing? So, what do you think is that situation that could possibly spoil God's plans for your life? What is that thing that you could go wrong or that you could even do that would make God's word of no effect in your life? As long as you don't give up on God, he won't give up on you. As long as you don't turn your back on him permanently, he will never put his back against you. And even if you have turned your back on him or given up, if you will turn back, you will find that he is exactly where he's always been, with his arms wide open waiting to receive you. You, my friend, may not have any answers about why what is happening is happening, but just trust that if you've done all, God is previous in your life. He's writing your story, and it is definitely going to be a good one. When you've done all and nothing seems to be changing, find comfort that he is working all things together for your good. Yes, really. Though weeping may endure for the night, joy, my friend, must come in the morning. No matter how long the night tarries, morning surely will come. I pray for you that you may experience God strengthen and fill you with his hope and comfort to wait through whatever you may be going through in this moment. May God bless you.